Hi, it's Thijs from Varnish, welcoming you to yet another episode of 2-Minute Tech Tuesdays. In this week's episode, we'll talk about an issue that occurs quite frequently in Varnish when you use caching and HTTP to HTTPS redirection. The consequence is that you often get stuck in an infinite redirect loop. And in this video, that will last more or less 2 minutes, so I'll put that on the timer already. I'll explain to you how the issue occurs and how you can resolve it. Imagine getting the following error message because a redirect loop was detected. When you check the details, you can see all the 301 redirects, and despite using HTTPS, you still get redirected to that same HTTPS resource. Although it doesn't make sense at first, when you look at the topology of your setup, it starts becoming clear. The web server has no prior knowledge of the original client connection being done over HTTPS. Because the TLS proxy terminates the TLS connection and uses plain HTTP in the back, the web server only sees Varnish, only sees that plain HTTP request, and issues the 301 redirect accordingly. The solution to that problem is issuing the X-Forwarded-Proto header in your TLS proxy and also in Varnish if required. That way, when the client connects to the TLS proxy, X-Forwarded-Proto will be set to HTTPS. However, if the client has a plain HTTP connection to Varnish, it will either be empty or HTTP. You need to build in TLS awareness into your application or web server, so that when a plain HTTP request is received prior to doing the 301 redirect, you check the value of X-Forwarded-Proto. If it's set to HTTPS, no need to redirect. If it's not set or set to HTTP, well, then you can issue the redirect. But it's equally important to set the X-Forwarded-Proto header in your TLS proxy. So whether you're using HAProxy or Apache or Nginx or Hitch, you need to set it. If you're using Hitch, assuming that you connect Hitch to Varnish over the proxy protocol, you can even use VCL for that. You do this by importing the proxy vmod and then using the proxy isSSL function to check whether or not SSL was used and set the values of X-Forwarded-Proto accordingly. We've just solved one issue, here's the next. Imagine that the first request you're sending is an HTTP request. The 301 redirect gets returned but also gets stored in the cache with no distinction between the protocol. So if the next request is an HTTPS request, you still get the 301. The way to tackle this is by issuing a vary header. In our use case, the vary header should be set to X-Forwarded-Proto, which means that Varnish should create a cache variation based on the value of the X-Forwarded-Proto request header. So that means a variation for HTTPS, where the content gets served, and a variation for HTTP, where the 301 redirect gets stored. You can set this in your web application, you can set this in your web server, you can even set it in VCL using the following code. That was 2-Minute Tech Tuesdays for this week. Although it seemed like a one-off episode and a bit of a random topic, it does occur a lot more than you would expect. So it makes a lot of sense to issue vary X-Forwarded-Proto, and it also makes a lot of sense to set the X-Forwarded-Proto value accordingly in your TLS proxy. Thank you for watching. I'll be back next week with yet another video.